So guys, what we have here is the Piston Excursion Calculator. All right, and a lot of people use this tool. Yeah, it's a website. You can go to the website, just type Piston Excursion Calculator, and you should find the website. So what this tool allows us to do is work out exactly what sort of sound pressure we should be expecting from a sealed enclosure subwoofer. And in this video, we're looking specifically at the KC62 from Kef. I will be looking at other subwoofers in future videos and running comparisons. Okay, I think a lot of people haven't come across this tool, and I thought it would be quite interesting and informative for people to know. So what we want to do is we want to solve this for a specific sound pressure that we're targeting. Now, let's say, for example, we're trying to hit a sound pressure of 100 decibels at 1 meter. Now here we can input our target frequency. So at the moment we're at 40 hertz, and here would be the driver diameter of the subwoofer and the number of drivers. This figure here is the X max. This relates to the linear excursion of the driver, and this is not to be confused with X mech, which is a different figure which we should not be paying attention to. We want to be looking at the X max. A lot of subwoofer manufacturers and speaker companies, they don't always publish the XMAX, so I would advise that you try to get this information if you can. And another thing I've heard is that companies tend to exaggerate the real XMAX, the linear excursion of their drivers, for whatever reason. I'm not sure, but I've heard sometimes they're 15% or so overstated. If I were you, I would type in a range of XMAXs so you can get a rough idea of what we should be expecting. Another thing to consider is that this is a decibel SPL at 1 meter. Now, I've always found that the 2 meter reading is probably more suitable, more accurate for your real world conditions. Don't know if you agree with me on that one, but that's what I found. And at the 2 meter reading, we would expect decibels to go down, I believe, by about 6 decibels. If you're aware about bass frequencies, the human ear can hear down to about 20 hertz. And I believe any figure that's stated below 20 hertz is not really relevant. It's of no use to us. What does it mean to us? We cannot perceive it. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to type the specifications of the Kef KC62. And this will give us the theoretical maximum sound pressure level that the subwoofer is able to generate. Now, it's assumed that your amp, or you know, your driver power, all that sort of stuff, that's not a factor. We're just working out theoretically what would be the maximum sound pressure. So what we do, we type, right, KC62, it has two drivers. Driver diameter, now it's 6.5 inches, I believe. Now, if you want to kind of understand about how this subwoofer might be able to perform at its loudest and do so in a linear fashion, then we could start this off at 20 hertz. Okay, and 20 hertz, it's saying here that we should realistically expect 83-ish decibels at 1 meter. Now, there's one thing that we didn't put in here, and that's the XMAX, which is measured in millimeters. Now, I've read, I'm not 100% sure what it is, but I think that the XMAX for the Kef KC62 is about 15 millimeters or 15 and a half. Now, again, this figure is rough. I don't believe it's a fixed value. So we'll just type in a range of values so you can see kind of what we can expect. Now, the more this XMAX goes up, the more bass we would expect the driver to produce. So we'll type in 10. And as you can see, we've gone from, I think it was 83 up to 89. So that's a doubling in amplitude. So we should expect almost double. I mean, it doesn't work exactly, but you should expect almost double in the perceived volume. I believe it's about between 6 and 10 decibels. I think 10 decibels for you to actually hear a doubling of the volume. So this tells us 89 decibels. Now, if we change that to 15.5, which I believe I've read in the white paper, that gives us a figure of 93 decibels, which is decent considering the size of the subwoofer. But if you're looking for a subwoofer that produces more bass, especially in the sub bass, then this subwoofer doesn't really look like it's cutting the mustard for me, because I think you could increase the size of the enclosure just a little bit and the subwoofer would still be compact, but I think you would get more back in return. So For example, if I were to change that to, let's say, a subwoofer with one driver, and then change that to a 12-inch driver, you see now we have gone up to 98 decibels. So we've gone up by 5 decibels. So that would be quite, I mean, you would hear that very, very clearly. Obviously, we're assuming that the X-Max is the same, which it will vary from company to company. That depends on the driver, so you need to look into that as well. Now, what would I recommend? Personally, a subwoofer for me, a real subwoofer's job is to be able to play low notes. It's to play them all for a start, and on top of that, it's to be able to play those lower notes with integrity. It's not to just play them. Now, I've been, you know, chatting with people in the YouTube comments for the last few days, and I'm trying to explain to people, if you had an orchestra and you took out some of the players from the bass section, the orchestra wouldn't sound very good anymore, would it? Now, while that is not an exact analogy, I still think it's very important, even for music, especially in today's age where we have synthesized music. My recommendation is you would want this decibel level to be at least 100 decibels. That's my advice if you want it to be good for music as well, because remember, this is at 1 meter. And if you're only going for one sub, you're going to have problems with positioning in the room. You're not always going to get maximum bass response from where you want to put the subwoofer to. So in most cases, I would actually recommend you buy two smaller subwoofers, rather than just one. So yeah, I just thought I would make this video just to bring some attention to this topic so people understand what is it that they really should be expecting for the money that they spend for the subwoofer. I know that, you know, it promises an 11 hertz extension and all that jazz, but I think that people need to understand this. And one more thing, and that is, this is really important as well, and that is the human ear doesn't work like a microphone does. It doesn't work so linearly. It doesn't work in such a linear fashion. Now, I can tell you that the human ear finds it much more difficult to perceive bass frequencies, and the lower down you go, the more decibels you need for it to sound the same. And I'm going to prove that to you now. So if you look at this website here, this is the Institute of Professional Sound, and it quite clearly says here, here's our normal listening range, here's our normal hearing range, 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. But it says, at low sound levels, for a sound at 50 hertz to be perceived as equally loud as a 1 kilohertz sound, the lower frequency would have to be about 30 decibels higher, but that's at lower volume. So at loud volumes, the ear is relatively more sensitive, but we would still need an additional 10 decibels. So basically, if we go back to this excursion calculator here, when we say 100 decibels at 20 hertz, your ear doesn't necessarily pick that up at exactly 100 decibels. And that's why there's a lot of people, they get these massive subwoofers because they're really trying to hit a target of like 115 or 120 decibels measured. But in reality, the whole system is only about 100 decibels or 105. So that's the thing about bass. That's the thing about subwoofers that people don't understand. Now, I hope this video makes your decision a little bit easier. I'm going to be making some more videos about this topic. I'm going to be comparing subwoofers to other subwoofers from other brands, so we can kind of have more of an understanding of what type of subwoofer we should be buying, what size should the cone be, the linear excursion of the driver, these sorts of factors. And that way, I think you will be able to buy the correct subwoofer, the correct equipment, and spend the right amount of money. And that way, you won't get any buyer's remorse.